Hi and welcome to this new sound comparison. Today we are going to compare two of the by far best budget speakers you can buy right now. On the left we have the DOS Soundbox XL, which I just received from the company for testing. It goes for $89 on Amazon, while the Dokken Define is a bit more pricey. I got it some months ago and it goes for 139 euros and it's only available in Germany. Of course you can do some importing, maybe via eBay or something, but it's quite hard to get in the States. So it's some kind of, unfair comparison because you can only get the Dokken here, but still I wanted to do it because the Dokken seems to be the only speaker which can really keep up to the DOS sound-wise. Both are really great sounding, although they feature quite a bit of a different sound philosophy. The DOS follows a very flat kind of hi-fi sound tuning, while the Dokken is rather tuned for fun. In the end I can already spoiler, it's really about you and which one you prefer for yourself. But maybe there are still some new things you can hear in this comparison. So please put on your headphones, as this is a normal microphone recording. I will be playing many kinds of musics. So for example, pop music, house music, jazz music, just the usual stuff. And in the end, we are also going to compare them at max volume to see which one maybe is the better party speaker. One more information, many people were complaining. The things you will see in some seconds are images. Those are not videos of the speakers, because many people are saying in my sound comparisons, oh, you just fake the comparison, the speaker drivers aren't even moving. Well, of course they aren't moving, because it's a image which you are seeing, and under the image I am putting the sound which I record with my microphone separately, which is just way less work to do than if I would do synced videos all the time to show you which speaker is playing. So those images are just showing you which one is playing right now, and those are not videos, just before you, write a hate comment where you are complaining why I'm faking the comparison or something. This is not fake. So again, please put your headphones, as this is a normal microphone recording, and enjoy the comparison.
Thank you. The day she got her first son, learned the secret technique of hate evasion. And surprised she didn't freak out when everything out of his mouth seemed a little Asian. Influenced and her mother looking down from the space station. Through them I learned I could be great, depending on which direction that I face, son. Happiness only takes one. But when you got two days less, lose them or lose, man, I might not make it amount of times I hit snooze. Wake up, Tyler, you ain't got nothing to lose. From the same stuff as the bruise. Now, we free from he who shall not be named. Dude, never been around where nothing could be gained. So, he can wallow in his shame. Was a hard pill to swallow. We took it the same. Remember all the times he tried to take me back. Pick me up from school and told me that I didn't need a pack. And I'd be on the plane.
There were people on the sidewalks.
Sidewalks.
And down the avenue.
Avenues.
Oh, sitting outside in cafes.
Cafes.
We were looking for the muse.
For the muse.
Well, I was locked in by the system. Where no freedom is the rule. Now I spend all my time. Make it understood.
Understood.
It once was my life.
Was my life.
That's what everybody said.
Everybody said.
All the things I used to do.
Used to do.
Yeah, the people that were friends.
That were friends.
So we are done now, and as you could hear, both of them are great performers, especially at their price point. Both sounded very nice on every volume step with any music, although it's really about the taste, and they also sounded quite different. First of all, let's clear up some things. Yes, the Dokken did sound a bit clearer, but this is not because it has more resolution or something, it's just because it has way more treble boost. It has a treble boost at about 5 kHz, which is the presence region, and this just makes it seem way clearer and more detailed sounding than the DOS, although the DOS actually I think has quite a bit more resolution. Still, it's really about you, what you like more. Some people might say, oh no, this treble hurts my ear, it's annoying after some time, and some people might say, well, I'm a bit deaf, so I like a bit of treble boost, but it's really about you and what you like more. And the second thing is that someone also commented under my video As we all know, the DOS has a slight issue with the base rattling, which is coming from a fabric mesh behind the metal grille, which is hitting the speakers when they move, and then it makes some very soft rattle sound with certain bass frequencies. Sadly, I couldn't fix it. With the older versions, the DOS XL version 1.0, you could take off the grille, take out the fabric, and then easily remove it. And many people in the comments told me to do this, and I wanted to try it. And they just, they don't have a gap at the bottom at the grille anymore, where you could lift the grille up easily with the older generation. And with the newer version, they somehow glued it on or made the slit a bit tighter. So I actually just scratched the plastic and couldn't get my screwdriver or a knife between the metal and the plastic, so this wasn't possible. And also someone in the comments told me that when you open it up or if you manage it, the fabric is actually glued onto the metal grill, so you cannot take it off anymore. So I'm really, I don't know, confused by what it is. And also maybe you could hear with some certain tracks that the docking sounded a bit more controlled, and that might be because some of the screws inside of the DOS might be loose. So if you really screw in the drivers a bit tighter when you took off the grill, the bass will become even more controlled and even better sounding. And sadly, I couldn't do all of this. So just imagine the DOS without the rattling and with a bit more precise bass, then we should have the, I don't know, real sound of the DOS, because like this, it is a great performer, but it still has some flaws with I don't know, certain tracks where you can hear the bass rattle. But now let's get into the overall sound. I personally, I think, have to give the edge to the DOS, not only because it's cheaper, but also because it sounds a bit more mature, a bit more adult on lower volumes or normal volumes. On max volume, you could hear that the Dokken hands down just won the competition. It sounded more powerful, it was louder, it had less compression and more bass kick. So on this hand, the Dokken definitely wins. I also think it's more some kind of, I don't know, modern music party speaker. So you could hear it has a bass boost at about 100 to 150 Hz. It's a little bit too strong for some tracks, but with modern music, it's actually even quite nice sometimes. On the other hand, it might sound a bit more powerful, but on the other hand, the DOS has the way deeper and more mature sounding bass, at least on normal volumes, because on max volume it loses this bass. But for normal volumes, I would give the edge to the DOS, unless you really only listen to modern music and you really don't notice this kind of upper bass boost with the Dokken. Some people might even enjoy it, or might even enjoy this kind of pushed, powerful sound. I personally really like the relaxed and smooth, the relaxed and smooth deep bass of the DOS. I just prefer it over the Dokken. You could hear it reaches down to about, I think, down to 50 or even lower, 50 Hz, and the Dokken only reaches down to about 70 Hz, and you really notice the difference with, I don't know, house tracks or something, where the DOS just sounds, I don't know, a bit more relaxed, a bit deeper, a bit more kicking, while the Dokken sounds very agile in the bass. It sounds very precise. So it really, again, depends on you, what you like more. Maybe you are kind of, I don't know, electronic music lover, and you say, oh, I really need some dynamic bass. It doesn't necessarily need to be very deep. It's just it just needs to sound very good. Then the Dokken probably is the right one for you. But if there are other people saying, I want some hi-fi sound with true deep bass for not that much money in a small package, which can sound great with any kind of music and never gets annoying or pushed forward too far, then the DOS definitely is the one for you. It's also the one for me, because again, I like this bass character of the DOS a bit more. But still, the Dokken also sounded great with some tracks. I even preferred it over the DOS, as it sometimes sounded a bit clearer. Again, it's the treble boost which makes it sound clearer, but this is sometimes just very helpful and really nice sounding with modern tracks. And with jazz music, I again had to give the edge to the DOS, just because it sounds flatter, more like hi-fi. Sometimes the mid sounded a bit clearer and a bit, a bit more natural or lifelike on the Dokken, maybe again due to the treble and mid-range boost, while on the other hand, the DOS sometimes had a slightly covered character to it, but this can also just result in the comparison, because of course, when you compare a speaker with a big treble boost to a speaker with no existing treble boost, it might sound covered. But I think that the DOS sometimes should need some more mid-range clearance, and maybe if you take off the grill, it will become better. But again, I couldn't do it because it's glued on, or because it's it's a sealed tighter, which is really sad because I think when I took off the grill, the DOS would have sounded even clearer than the Dokken, really clearer, and not just because of a treble boost or something. So overall, again, my verdict is you should really, again, maybe listen to the video again and make your own decision. Don't forget to put up the headphones when you want to listen again, because this gives you the most realistic sound impression, because it's really about you. Both speakers sounded very nice on max volume. I would maybe give the edge again to the Dokken because it sounded more powerful and a bit louder also. On normal volumes, I personally would prefer the DOS, but if you prefer the Dokken, I can totally understand it because it just sounds different and maybe it sounds better to some people. But for me, I would recommend the DOS on normal volumes, but again, it's totally about your personal opinion. So if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like or subscribe to the channel to see many more of those kind of comparisons. Until then, have a great time and bye bye!